This is example number 26 and our second example for find and replace. Here is our input file. To the right of each input string, I have given an arrow symbol and shown what the string should look like after the replacement is done. The input strings are names of persons. The strings follow the format, the first name, followed by a space, followed by the last name. The first string is John space Wallace. We want to capture the first name and last name from this string and then restructure the string in another way. So for John Wallace, the new string should be Wallace, comma John, which is of the format last name, comma first name. So we need to capture the first name from the input string and rearrange it as shown. Let's move to step 2 now. Here, I have tried to represent the input string using regex patterns. Let's start reading from left to right. I have represented the first name using a character class for lowercase a to z as well as uppercase a to z in square brackets followed by plus. The square brackets indicate a character class for English letters. Why do we need lowercase as well as uppercase ranges? Note that the first name as well as the last name begin with a capitalized letter, which is why we need both lowercase and uppercase ranges inside the character class. And the plus means one or more occurrences. So the A to Z plus stands for a name formed with one or more English letters. I have enclosed this A to Z plus within a set of parentheses. This pattern captures the first name and assigns a particular number to it, backslash 1. If we keep moving from left to right again, next is the space represented by backslash S. We don't need to capture this because our final transformed string does not use this space. It only reuses the first name and last name from the original string. For this reason, we do not enclose backslash s within parentheses. We just write it as such. Let's keep moving again from left to right. The representation for the last name is done in a similar way using the character class and the plus symbol. Again, we enclose it using another set of parentheses. The orange box represents the first capture. It's our capture number 1. The exact identification is backslash 1. You can see that written in a small white font towards the top of the orange box. We prefix a backslash escape character so that the 1 is not treated as a literal in our substitution string, which we will be seeing shortly. The green box represents the second capture, capture group number 2. We identify it with backslash 2. Now we have captured 2 patterns in all, group number backslash 1 and group number backslash 2. Let's now move to the final step. Here we come up with a replacement string. The string should be of the format last name, comma, first name. So we write down this phrase and in place of the first name and last name, we use the capture groups. So when the replacement engine sees backslash 2, it will go back and see what the capture group number 2 was. It will take the contents of capture group number 2, which was the last name, and put it in the position of backslash 2. Similarly, the backslash 1 is replaced with the contents of the first capture group, which is the first name. So our solution for example number 26 is a set of two regex patterns. The first pattern is what we came up with in step 2. The second pattern is our substitution pattern, which we came up with in step 3. Let's try this out now. Let's bring up our Linux terminal. First, let's see our input file. So cat input file name. There you go. Now sed hyphen r and in single quotes s forward slash. We'll type in our search regex pattern for this example. Another forward slash. We'll type in our replacement regex pattern for this example. Another forward slash. G. And then the input file name for this example. There you go. So compare the result here with what you saw in the graphic for this example. Both should match. So that's it for this session. Let's move on to the next one.